Hi, this is Ramakoteswar Rao, Veeravalli. In earlier video, I explained about WordPress. In this video, I am going to tell about the how to create the WordPress. For creating WordPress, the basic requirements are: first, we need internet and laptop or either computer system. Second, we require local server. We said these local servers are WAMP or XAMPP. This WAMP stands for Microsoft Windows Operating System. XAMPP stands for Cross Platform Web Server. Abbreviation of this XAMPP is X Cross Platform, A Apache, M MariaDB, P PHP, P Perl. Third, we need WordPress package. Finally, we require PHP and MySQL Server. Then we selected WordPress.com site. Once we click on that WordPress.com, on the right side of the screen you can see get started and login options. Then first, we selected get started option. There you can see like this. First, it will ask what name you are going to put, for what purpose you are going to use that WordPress site, what is the aim of your site. Then give your site address, that means which name you want to open that website. Some X, we mentioned that name of site. Later on, there are three options: either personal, premium, business. If we use it for share our information personally, we click on personal options. Premium means we have to pay some amount to that website. Business means some industry people, they require that WordPress. And then normally for education purpose, we go for the personal option. Finally, we have created our account with email address and password. Then we enter into the login option. We give whatever the user ID and password, we use it to start the WordPress. After entering to the website, we can see screen like this. Then you click on my site option, which is on the left side on the screen, top portion. There you can see on left side different options, view site, status of that website, what is your plan, site pages, blog posts, media, comments, feedback, testimonials. If you select the site pages, there you can mention what about your website, your contact number, blog, and you can also give your address, what is your research area, like that. If you select, if you on left side below that, there are some other options, sharing, people, plugins, domains. If you select the sharing option, you can share your information through Google, Twitter, etc. If you select the people option, you can invite the other people in your website. Now I will wait for few seconds to recap what I explained in this video. Thank you.